Hello. I'd like to make today cake pixels for movie which has come out recently. And what we need for this recipe, we use a cake ball tins. They come with stands like that. Good idea when you bake them to place on a tray. It just makes it easier to transfer in place in the oven. Also, before you're using grease your cake tins with melted butter or just butter to smudge all around nice and generously. It makes just cake not stick. So also with this particular cake ball cake tins usually works very well, more like a type of pound or firm texture cake batter. Like for example, butter cake, I use packet of rich chocolate cake. It's quite a large packet. Use packet about 550 gram or about 18 ounces. Nice and large packet. Divided among two ball cake halves and place in the oven to bake for about an hour on 160 degrees Celsius, all Fahrenheit. I will write in a description box. But I will place just a basic chocolate recipe in the description box if you like to use a basic chocolate recipe, which is will work as well with this ball cake tins. So once we prepare the chocolate cake according to instruction, we grease our ball tins with butter and we bake it. So once you bake it, leave it in a tin for about 10 minutes before you invert onto wire rack to completely cool down. So next step is to place our prepared cakes, and I use a small cake board, so you can use a serving plate. And also, I just bake mini cupcakes. Also, you can use just a standard cupcakes, which is we place characters on top of these cupcakes. Just to bake a batch of chocolate cupcakes if you like to do so. Mini or standard doesn't really matter. So we have two halves of the chocolate cake baked in a ball tin. So we leave one half as it is, but use a serrated knife to make sure you level both cakes nice and straight, to make sure they sit on top of each other nicely. And take one of halves, which is we you will use as a bottom half. And what you do is take serrated knife and just simply slice it to make sure your bottom part will sit flat as well. So this our bottom part, and we have a buttercream. I will place recipe in the description box, but it's a basic buttercream, and which is I use lemon yellow and a small amount of golden yellow to achieve the color of the pixel ball. So what we do is we take small amount of buttercream, tinted buttercream. We place our bottom cake, which is we flatten. Make sure we're able to place it right on the middle. And we simply apply yellow buttercream on top of it, and we sandwich with a top cake. So this is our top cake, and we place it on top. So what we do is next, we actually cut out kind of like a mouth. Also, if you like it, make a larger pixel ball. What you do is simply using a glass heat proof bowl, nicely, generously grease with butter or cooking spray, and you can make it two of those and join, and you will get much larger type of cake. So, also if you're not able to find it, basically bowl shape. So, what to do is use serrated knife, and what we do is we just cut out top and cut out bottom part as if a mouse would open, and nicely remove it. And what you do is next simply cut out just a little bit of corners to make it look like it's mouse actually open. So remove it all bits, make it nice and straight. And what we do is next, before we apply yellow buttercream, take a piece of paper and just place it on top right here like that, because you will know how much of black fondant you will cut out. So simply place it on, trim it to size of open mouth. This one is top, and here will be the bottom part of mouth. Simply trim it, and you will know how much of black fondant we need to cut out to actually basically cover the mouth. So this is top, this is bottom. So once we've done this, next step is simply use the yellow tinted buttercream and apply on top of cake. So once you cover your bowl with yellow buttercream, what you do is it doesn't have to be precise, because it's kind of like a pixel sort of shape. We cannot make it squares on top, but what we do is just lift it up a little bit, your knife, and it just makes a little bit surface uneven. So what we do is next, we attach a mouth. Top mouth I already done. So what we do is we take our bottom mouth, which is we checked before, place on a black color fondant, roll out on your working surface, sprinkled with powdered icing sugar to prevent sticking, cut out shape, and what we do is next, we actually cut out like a sort of pixel type of squares. So we do large one in front, a little bit smaller, do exactly same on other side, and just keep going, look like it's later, just keep going like that. And on the end we a little bit snip and as well. So as you can see, this how a bottom part of mouth is look like. It's the same as the top. So we take small amount of yellow frosting and just apply to make sure we're able to attach. Make sure we're able to attach our mouth. So what we do is we just simply place it right on the bottom and just a little bit straighten up to make sure it looks nice and tidy. And we cut out two eyes from a black fondant as well, and we simply attach them on top. Just to make sure they're nice and straight. And here we are. Next step is I like to make some type of sky blue pixels because we place inside a cupcakes as well like it comes out from ours of the Pac-Man. So what we do is we have it a bag of white chocolate melt. We melt it on top of saucepan with simmering water or in the microwave. Use a sky blue or electric blue type of coloring. Simply add gel food coloring and incorporate it all together to make sure you achieve this color of pixels. If it's not enough, just simply get a little bit more. So mix it all together. Then we can pour into basically square baking pan or microwave type of dish, which is lined with non-stick baking paper. Once you add enough to achieve color you wanted, also you can use a blue, a light blue colors candy melts, or add even them to basically your chocolate. So what we do is we just simply pour into prepared dish lined with non-stick baking paper, and we just spread it to make it square. So what we do is let it just set for a few minutes, but do not let set completely, because we actually won't cut this mixture into squares. Just tap a little bit to make sure surface appear to be nice and straight, doesn't have any fold. Just shake a bit. As you can see, it's quite good, and let it set for just few minutes, but do not let set completely, and we actually cut on little squares. By the time when our chocolate pixels are setting up, in my kitchen it's very warm, so I have to wait a little bit longer, so before we actually cut them. So good idea if whatever you're using, a mini cupcake like that or a standard cupcake, print the image of characters, which main characters like Inky, Blinky, Clyde and Pinky, and basically on a size to fit your cupcake, mini cupcake or cupcake, simply. So cut it out and your template is done. So whatever you have, and this is particular Blinky, so we have it red color fondant, roll out on a working surface, sprinkle with powdered icing sugar, and what we do is we just cut it out. According to shape. So what we do is simply just follow all patterns. We need only cut out one template because they are similar color, and simply use a small sharp type of knife where is you able to cut out easier. Something you do in the bottom part, and you cut out all colors you need, as well as how many do you want it. Some other option I will show you after that. This we cut out from our fondant. It's quite easy and fast, and as you can see, Blinky already done. Set on a non-stick baking paper. If you like, you can even cut out a little eye as well to make it just so easy for you. And basically what you do is cut out a rectangular shape from white fondant. Make sure you have two of those, because we have two eyes. and simply cut out exactly same. And as you can see, shape is already done. So we need to do second one as well with a blue fondant. We just need cut out two small squares. Here we are. And we simply attach all parts with a little bit of water. Just brush small amount, attach right on top, slightly press it in to make sure it's set good. Remove any parts which is not straight. Brush with a little bit water and attach on top for the eye. Something repeat with the other eye. Once our blue chocolate is set, so take it out from your shape, and it's not set, it's actually still kind of soft, so it's actually not completely hard. So take a nice and big knife and simply, good idea, I have hot knife as well, makes job much easier. So kind of pressing in. If you break few pieces, it doesn't really matter because we do not need huge amount. We will place the pixels inside mini cupcakes, or if you're using cupcake. And so once you make plenty of those, so say you have one of these ones, and we simply cut into little squares. So we can get chocolate pixels. Once you cut all them, what you do is let set completely, make sure it's nice and hard. Here our characters are ready now. As you can see, they're really nice and cute. So what we do is next, basically, if you do not want to use a fondant, you can easily use a different color tinted chocolate and print it something like a pixel, for example, image to fit your cupcake or mini cupcake. Make sure it's actual fit on a top, otherwise it will be doesn't look too good. So place image under non-stick baking paper. Place a melted white chocolate into piping bag and simply start carefully piping all the details and use a toothpick to place into shape. Once you've done that, place in a refrigerator to completely set. Once pixels nice and hard, they look like a nice and square. So what you do is take just an average chocolate frosting. We need very small amount. Take a little bit and just smudge just in front of mouth. So look like it's actually it's pixels. So what we do is, and we simply attach small amount. If you're able to find some sort of sweets, similar type of shape, please do use those. It would be probably easier. And just simply attach a little bit like this. So with the rest of blue pixels, what we do is we just take our mini chocolate cupcake. Open a cavity. As you can see, we can fit some of our pixels inside, just like this. Just to put few nice chocolatey. Just a four probably be enough. What you do is, this is a lid which is we open our cavity. Just make it flat. Make sure we're able to attach back, just like this. And place a chocolate frosting into piping bag. Fit it with a large rose type of nozzle. Pipe it on top, generous amount. And what we do is, this one is already done. It's a little bit set, so we will place the pinky on top. And with the chocolate, we will place our pixel. So carefully just lift it up paper. And here our miniature pixel. So what we do is we just simply place on top. And we're done. As you can see, this looks really, really cute. Now we finish pixel cake. As you can see, it's actually come out quite good. I just bring up a little bit closer, make sure you're able to have a look on the details. And also pixels comes out as well. If you want, you can actually make more chocolates and put it inside actual ball to make it like a piñata sort of. And if you like, you can substitute the chocolates for simple square sweets type of color, a blue one, if you like it. And this is a main characters of a movie. Inky, Blinky, Clyde, and Pinky, as well as we done a pixel as well. So we place small amount of the tinted chocolate inside, and it looks like piñata. Thank you very much for your time with me today. I hope you like this creation. Of course, you can make it just a normal standard cupcakes also. Everything will be in description box. Until next time, goodbye.